Greetings, ladies and mental gents, and welcome to this latest rendition of Tales from Outer Space. Taken from the subreddit HFY, all the relevant links will be down below. And as always, I hope that you enjoy, and if you do, please consider supporting the channel. Now, on to the science fiction. Quest for Perfection, written by RegalLegalEagle. Orleans Majoris was a planet at the edge of nothing, far beyond the borders of even the most far-flung spacefaring nations. It was as distant as a planet could possibly be while still actually being a part of the galaxy. It was also a harsh and desolate planet with a near-toxic atmosphere and an incredibly inhospitable surface that suffered constant violent storms. Any cursory surveys would send any ships to the next planet in a hurry, and likely the next system altogether, as the Orleans system itself was uninteresting and barren. Yet this planet held a very closely kept secret, a facility buried underground, connected to hundreds of very carefully crafted craters along the surface that were camouflaged dishes. For a secret order, a monk had slowly and carefully turned this planet into a repository for knowledge and the media of the galaxy, if not the universe. History had warned of errors across all civilized species where knowledge could become lost due to many factors, and these monks had set themselves into a tireless effort to reserve and safeguard this knowledge. They had taken a sacred oath to be the guardians of what they considered to not just be enlightenment, but culture. Of the best and the worst, all so that triumphs and mistakes could all be preserved for future generations to know. They had also forgotten their names and set aside notions of self and species, for they wished to make no distinction between fellow preservers or those that they would one day uplift from ignorance. Their mission was seen as a betterment of all sapiens and a task to be taken with the utmost seriousness. Few were selected to join their ranks, and fewer still would actually make the trek and take the vows. But all were celebrated as beloved equals of their ranks in annual ceremonies. Thus, a grand door was preserved for these to enter through when the storms on the planet were the weakest. A solemn yet joyous day for the Order. For the rest of the year, the door was shut and the grand entryway quiet, tended to by a single gatekeeper. The gatekeeper had joined the Order a decade ago and fully enveloped himself in his duties. This year, he had become the gatekeeper. His life before was cast aside, his identity changing as the Order needed. Every task he'd been given sacred and important in some way. For now, he spent his days before the next opening in quiet contemplation, sweeping, cleaning, or tending to the plants that lined the entryway to give beautiful color to the contrast and dour of the hostile environment outside the door. His days were full of peace and meditation, seeing others only during his morning and evening meals in the nearest dining hall. So it came as a great surprise to him when he carefully tended the Gartaban plasma lily that there was a knock at the massive door behind him. The gatekeeper paused at his work and turned to look at the massive metal doors. Had it been his imagination? Had the storm thrown something against it? This was one of the worst seasons on the surface, after all. But then he heard it again. It was insistent now, quick, rapid knocks. The gatekeeper rose up, setting aside his tools and adjusted his robes. As far as he had known, this had never happened before. What should he do? The knocking continued. He had a duty to protect and assist fellow sapiens, did he not? Maybe there had been a crash and someone was in need of help. His four legs carried him forward slowly, cautiously, as he reached the door. The knocking kept going. There was some nervous rustling as he folded his four hands over and then pressed on the control to open the door. Perfectly maintained hinges and gears gliding open quietly to open the door just a crack. There was a small figure just at the crack of the door, bundled up in a rather mismatched assortment of warm clothes, pressure suit, and an unusual silvery-gray adhesive wrapping around most of the fabric. The gatekeeper did not judge other species, but the small biped before him was one of the younger species, he was fairly sure. He hoped his translator had the young species' language programmed. "Greetings, wayward sapient. I am Gatekeeper. Are you in immediate danger? What?" The figure adjusted some goggles on his face, putting them away so that they could better look up at the gatekeeper through the narrow opening in the door. "No, just a bit cold, but I'm not in immediate danger. Has your ship crashed on this planet and you are in need of assistance?" the gatekeeper asked next. "No, well, the landing was rough, but it's in three pieces, or less, which really qualifies as a great landing, right?" The little figure laughed in a way that the gatekeeper suspected was manic, but he did not judge. "This vicinity is not open to outsiders, I'm afraid. Well, I welcome you as a fellow sapient. I can share with you some of my midday meal if you require sustenance, but I cannot allow you entrance," the gatekeeper explained. "Wait, this is the right place, isn't it?" the figure asked then. "You guys are the ones that collect all the media in the galaxy, right?" At this, the gatekeeper felt his unease settle. A wayward knowledge seeker, then. It happened, though he didn't think they ever made it to the surface. "I am sorry, my fellow sapient, but our order must maintain strict rules. Cannot allow entry to any outside our order. Even if you seek the meaning of life or the secrets of the universe, our repository is merely here to preserve the collective transmissions of all sapient life," he tried to explain. "I am not looking for any secrets or meanings or whatever. Listen, my name is..." the figure started, but the gatekeeper held up two hands. "My fellow sapient, dear, we have transcended beyond the need for self-monikers as names and have all shed our past so as to focus on our tasks and to ensure our order does not become listed in the very knowledge we seek to collect. I am the gatekeeper only, and I ask you to keep your name to yourself so as to not taint anything I might read of you in the future and add unwanted context to the transmission or media," the gatekeeper explained. Well, fine." The figure shifted, seeming off-put. The gatekeeper expected this from the outside of the order. "Well, anyway, my species," he tried again, yet the gatekeeper held up his hands once more. "Here, we have also transcended the idea of individual species as well. We all are one shared collection of sapients, and to label ourselves by our mortal physiology beyond the needs of medical or dietary restraints is counterproductive to our quest of perfect understanding. I ask you to please refrain from identifying your species to be as well, so I do not add it unwanted context." The gatekeeper wanted to be gentle yet firm. The entire interaction was already exceptionally unusual. "Fine, I'm only here for a single video anyway. I've traveled across the galaxy and braved many perils to get you. I've risked life and limb to get here based on the rumors of your existence. You have no idea how much I need this. If I could just..." the figure tried next. "I am sorry, fellow Xavian, but we cannot help you. No matter how much of a loss the beloved may hurt, or however much you think a lost video of their presence will help, it's not quite our place." The gatekeeper started, but this time he was interrupted. "What? No, it's not a video of a dead person, or at least I hope they're still alive. It would be really awkward if they're not. No, I need it because I've been looking..." The gatekeeper frowned. "We cannot provide you closure of a crime either. It is not our place to justice or evidence." The two of them were now locked in a back and forth of interruptions. "I am not a criminal either, swear. I just need it so I can find some historical videos pertaining to your religion. Any such religious documents would..." The gatekeeper was starting to run out of ideas as to why the figure could be here. "I mean, hey, it might be close to a religious experience when I watch it, but no religion either. It's just seeking us for some video, which you can sell is a bit strictly. It's not about money, it's just the best horn tugger of a flick I've ever seen." When the figure finally blurted out what the video was for, the gatekeeper paused. He was taught not to judge other sapiens for many various reasons, physiology especially. But as he examined the figure before him, he blinked. "Fellow sapient, I am confused. You do not appear to possess a horn. Was it hidden under their cranial fuzz? What? Who told you that? It's a dirty lie, it is. I'm totally average at worst. I know some people say that being average isn't great, but when it comes to measuring, the third leg average is totally acceptable. One of the mall gatekeeper.
Once more, the gatekeeper blinked in confusion. He saw two legs.
Where was the third? I'm sorry, I don't understand what you mean, he confessed. You know, spanking the monkey, giving the crank, making the bald man cry, five-finger shuffle, riding the mayonnaise surf, debugging the hard drive.
The gatekeeper blinked again.
Auditioning the hand puppet, tugging the slug, battling the purple-headed yogurt slinger, shaking hands with Dr. Winky. Perhaps there is something wrong with my translator,
the gatekeeper muttered.
Oozing your noodle squirt hockey, celebrating Palm Sunday, burping the worm, wrestling the eel, strangling the cyclops. 23 skidoo, seriously guy, you must know what I mean.
Jerking the gherkin, beef stroganoff. The two stared at each other for another second before the smaller figure finally snorted.
Wanking! I need the video from the spank bank. A bank? I'm not sure we have security footage from banks. Our mission here requires that the media be brought. No, it's not a literal bank. We have no idea how good it was. This was a gold standard of videos. I know I should have found a way to download it, but I was young and foolish. Once I loaded it up, it would take me like 5 seconds to finish. It was that good. And then one horrible night, in answer to my query, quoth the server 404.
The gatekeeper could hear the anguish in the figure's voice.
I'm still not sure, he started. Please, you have no idea what I've done to get you. I've crossed scorching deserts, braved perilous seas, and fought more than my fair share of bandits and pirates just to make it this far. And trust me, there is no replacement for it. I've been with actual, real living sapiens in the meantime, and I still want that video. That's how good it is.
The gatekeeper was at a loss. Clearly, this figure would not relent. If he denied him entry, he would likely just stay outside. Well, what did he do?
He held up a hand. One moment.
Backing away from the door, he quickly shuffled over to the wall to tap a call to the high admin. There was a soft chirp as he was connected.
I am sorry to disturb you, high admin, but this is the gatekeeper. There is someone at the door they want peace and love to your brother, gatekeeper. I am surprised to hear from you, but you should know that we cannot allow entry to an outsider.
The admin replied.
Yes, high admin, I'm aware. However, they are seeking a video. You know as well as I, gatekeeper, that we simply cannot share that which we have acquired, lest we alter the path of context across history and culture. No religious, no, I tried all that. It's nothing like that, apparently. It's a young race species that keeps talking about strange things like choking the purple worm or something. I'm very confused, High Admin. I do not wish to pass judgment on the younger species, but you must mediate, gatekeeper. I am saddened to hear you bring judgment or context to a fellow sapient of any species or...
High Admin paused. Wait, it's a human, isn't it? His voice suddenly full of wariness and possible contempt.
The gatekeeper leaned back and looked at the figure in the tiny crack of the door. Do you identify as human? Yeah, sure, I'm good old human being. I thought you didn't want to know my species. Would it be better if I said I'm a meat popsicle? It's freezing out here.
The figure shivered a moment, rubbing their limbs.
Yes, I think I admit that it is a human.
The gatekeeper looked back at the screen.
Our order remains secret for centuries, and then they go and discover FTL travel, I swear.
The high admin sounded uncharacteristically annoyed.
Just have the lawyer deal with it. We have a lawyer.
The gatekeeper glanced around.
How do I contact them? I was unaware we had a former lawyer in our order, but do we not shed
he started, but the high admin waved him off. Not a former lawyer, a current lawyer. It was a necessary evil. Once the humans started showing up at this very reason, just say that you need a lawyer. They'll deal with the rest. The high admin then turned off the call, and the gatekeeper looked around for a moment. Help! I need a lawyer, he said aloud. Yes! A figure suddenly appeared behind him. Ah! The gatekeeper jumped as the figure jumped out of the shadows beside him. Unlike the simple robes of all other members of the Order wore, this figure had on a dark gray suit. How did you? I could sense your legal need had appeared, the lawyer announced, knowing his question. Really? The gatekeeper gasped, now confused about the nature of the species. No, my office has an alarm for the door opening and I came down. Then I just waited in the shadows until it was almost dramatic to make my presence known. The lawyer explained and stepped back over to the door. You're looking for a single adult video, correct? Yes, the other human nodded. Here, sign this. Do you need a knife so that you can cut yourself and sign in blood? The lawyer asked as she pulled out an expensive and ornate-looking dagger from her suit pocket. What is it? The human asked as he started to flip through the pages. It's a standard NDA, the lawyer answered. Ah, hence the blood. Right. A standard NDA. Do I need a whole lot of initials? I don't want to pass out, the traveler asked. Just 3 initials and 1 signature. Then you get the video in question. But if you ever reveal our presence to anyone, the file will delete itself and all your other porn. So, no talking. The lawyer pointed accusingly at the other human. That's a bit much, isn't it? The lawyer just stared down at the other human. Dagger, please. The gatekeeper watched as the figure outside took the dagger through the small opening and took off a glove so that they could cut their fingertip and sign the papers. Initial, signature. Done. Now, what's the video? The lawyer asked as she took back the dagger and papers. You won't judge me, right? The human asked. I assure you that our order is free of any prejudice of flesh. The gatekeeper nodded. Here's the search terms. It should be the first result, but I expect to see it first. The human crumbled and handed over the slip of paper to the lawyer. Disgusting, she murmured. Hey, he promised no judgment. The traveler whined with a wave at the gatekeeper. He did. I didn't, freak. The lawyer replied and turned, but he called out. How did you get the job here anyway? This made the lawyer pause and look back. Like all lawyers, I was made manifest by legal necessity, she said very seriously. Really? He asked, obviously surprised. No, you idiot. I was looking for my favorite bean flicking flick when it was taken down for copyright reasons. So like any normal person, I traveled across the galaxy to find a secret order of video collecting nutjobs rather than pay for the video. Now I have access to the galaxy's largest porn collection. It's pretty great, she nodded slowly. Do you think that I am? The other started. No. The lawyer hissed out and walked over to the console on the wall. After a few minutes, she walked back and handed the other human a small data pad. This it. Yes. The gatekeeper backed up a moment as the hiss let out by the traveler. It was almost as if something had possessed them in that moment. Thanks. I'm off to my ship. I've got a perfect chair set up and tons of energy drinks, so I don't get dehydrated. Bye. With that, the figure waved and scurried off before the lawyer shut the door. I'm not sure I understand, the gatekeeper mentioned as the lawyer turned to leave. Not all quests for perfection involve secrets to the universe's gatekeeper. Many who seek enlightenment need to make answers for themselves. But you have no idea what a human will go through to find the perfect video for a nut. For some, it is a doomed quest that ends in disgust and disappointment. But the journey must still be undertaken just the same. For often, we discover that it was not the object of our memory that we most desire, but the moment lost in time that we can never return to. And that particular vid was some lost droplet of sanctuary in the torrid affairs of our lives. Yet, often, it is the porn we find along the way that we come to cherish in the end. The lawyer nodded slowly, and the gatekeeper felt that he had much to learn.
But, sometimes, the lawyer continued, sometimes it is just really that good and you feel like you just blew your brains out. But in a good way. Anyway, I'm off to my lawyer lair. Call me if you need any NDAs or injunctions. And don't worry too much about what happened today. It'll make sense to you when you get assigned to floor 34.
The gatekeeper was once more left alone with his thoughts as the human walked away, her suit seeming to vanish into the shadows like the natural camouflage of some predatory species. He slowly scuffled back to tend to his plants as he started to contemplate what had happened today. While he had come to expect much from the knowledge seekers of the galaxy, he had to add a new sinking suspicion that this species would make it hard for him not to pass judgment. Something told him that in his quest for perfection, humans were going to make things weird. End of story. And that, my friends, concludes this video. I hope that you enjoyed, and if you do, please consider supporting the author, even by popping over and leaving a thumbs up or a nice comment, just to show your appreciation for the story. However, if you wish to support this channel, there are links down below which will help immensely. I will see you all in the next one, and until then, I hope that you have a fantastic day. Cheers.